who addresses on the topic of religion, violence, and the modern world. We are honored to have with us today Imam Hamza Yusuf from the United States of America. Imam Hamza Yusuf, as they say in Arabic, is ghaniyun anit ta'rif. He's in no need of any introduction. He's the director of Zaytuna Institute and a well-known personality in the Western Muslim community as well as the Muslim world. We are grateful for him for accepting our invitation despite his busy schedule. And I believe this is his last public event in the UK. As most of you are well aware, Imam Hamza has been on a tour of the United Kingdom. I'd like now Imam Hamza Yusuf to come to the podium and deliver his talk. Imam Hamza Yusuf.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah wa ala sayyidina wa habibina afdari khalqillah Muhammad ibn Abdillah وعلى آله وصحابته ومن والاه ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله الحمد لله. First of all, I appreciate the invitation. Unfortunately, because this talk is the last of the talks, you're looking at a reasonably spent force. I've been here for 2 weeks, and so I've been a little exhausted the last few days. And I'm hoping that I can possibly keep my thoughts together enough to get through this. I thought it was interesting that on the door over there, they have three scimitars that are really symbolic of Islam traditionally in the West, and they're turned upside down, which was a common symbol in the West to turn the Muslim sword upside down. I don't know why there's three. I'm curious as to the symbolism of that and who put it up there and what they were thinking. But there's also another interesting piece of symbolism there, which is a painting that has history in the back, and then there's several historical images there. And one of the things about a civilized society is that they always place a very important emphasis on history. Because if you don't place an important emphasis on history, you will lose the opportunity of gaining so much of the wisdom and benefit that exists in the study of history. If you look at the Quran is actually one-third a type of history. It's sacred history. It's not a history that is verifiable with footnotes or sources, and that could be said as well about the Old Testament. And the Old Testament is very difficult to prove historically. In fact, most of the material in the Old Testament is ahistorical, although it's dealing with very historical issues. So the Old Testament is a history book, and one could argue also that the New Testament is a history book, although it's a sacred history book, and many historians, modern historians, completely reject it. And there are historians that actually don't believe there was ever a person named Abraham, that it's a mythological figure like Osiris or Vishnu. And particularly you'll find this in continental history. Germany has a tradition of over 100 years of basically denying the existence of historical figures, sacred historical figures that Muslims, Christians, and Jews all believe are actual human beings that did live. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran says, "Afalam yusiru fil ard," you know, haven't they traveled in the earth? And in other verses, "Siru fil ard, fandhuru." كَيْفَ كَانَ عَاقِبَةُ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْرِكُمْ. Travel in the earth and look at those who went before you. That's essentially a command, and it's in the imperative, siru. It's a command, although the command in the Quran can be used for obligations as well as recommendations. But it is a command in the Arabic to study history,
to actually look at the peoples that went before you and think about what brought them to destruction. Why were they destroyed? Now, what's very interesting is Arnold Toynbee studied 21 civilizations. And Arnold Toynbee actually credits Ibn Khaldun as being one of his major influences, because Ibn Khaldun was somebody who studied dynasties and attempted to understand why they came to destruction, why they actually ended the way that they did. And that is the Quranic imperative, to actually look and see why they came to an end. How was their aqibah? And why did they get there? Now, Arnold Toynbee studied 21 civilizations, and he found that they followed certain patterns. And he actually identified 4 stages. What's interesting is one of the stages was a militaristic stage. It was a stage in which the society became basically an economy and a civilization that was based on military might and power. And that was often followed by this period of conquest and then luxury